The Birla family has had over a three-decade-old association with Gurudev and Chinmaya Mission, where every year the late Sarlaji Birla and Basant Kumarji hosted the Gyan Yagnas in Kolkata. The late Aditya Birlaji was the chairman of Gurudev's Yagna Committee as well. The association continues with Rajshriji Birla as the chairperson of the Chinmaya Mission Mumbai 50th Year Celebration Committee earlier, and now as the chairperson of the Chinmaya Anand Utsav to be held in December 2015. Rajshriji Birla has had the good fortune to spend time with Gandhiji and was greatly influenced by his beliefs. An ardent student of the Bhagavad Gita, she takes strength from the phrase, "This too shall pass," which has helped her hold steady and continue on her path of philanthropy, focusing her strength and energy on the corporate social responsibility projects of the Aditya Birla Group. As chairperson of the Aditya Birla Center for Community Initiatives and Rural Development, the apex body responsible for development projects, Mrs. Birla oversees the group's social and welfare-driven work across 30 companies. Approximately 3,000 villages and 18,000 students have benefited by the initiatives taken by her and her team. Mrs. Birla is also a Padma Bhushan awardee and also a recipient of the Golden Peacock Global Award for Corporate Social Responsibility. A firm believer in gender equality, she has spoken strongly on Indian women as the guide for the world at crossroads. It is indeed our privilege to have Rajshriji with us this evening. May I request Mrs. Birla to share her thoughts and memories with us.
Pooja Swami, Swatmanaji, Dr. Sheth, and Anand Biljit Singh, and my fellow seekers. We meet here on this very auspicious day, a day of celebration, as well as a day of thanksgiving to the Lord for having sent Swami Chinmayananji in our midst 100 years ago. Swamiji is a timeless guru. His spirit always lives with us. His preachings are like the words of God, a blessing upon mankind. I am most honored to be here today and to share some of the treasured memories that I have of Guruji. It all goes back to nearly 50 years when I came into the Birla household. I would see Guruji at our family house in Kolkata. I found a great spiritual bonding between my parents-in-law, Dr. Sarla Devi Birla and Sri Basant Kumarji Birla with Swamiji. Whenever Swamiji would come to Kolkata, he would always stay with my parents-in-law. When I first met Guruji, I was just 17 years old. I found Guruji very charismatic, always cheerful, and with a great sense of humor. Since I was so young, I was overawed by his persona. Honestly, I was quite inhibited. In a lighter vein, whenever Guruji spoke in his South Indian accent, I could understand it best because I also come from Madurai. And Adityaji would always tease me about this, saying that I understand Guruji better than him. I remember Guruji conducting the Gita Gyan Yagya every year at one of our Birla schools in Kolkata. I also recount the deep admiration and respect with which my grandfather-in-law, Sri Ghanshyam Dasji Birla, held Guruji. Daoji, as we called my grandfather-in-law, used to have a copy of Guruji's Gita by his bedside. Adityaji was very close to Daoji, and so naturally he also became an ardent follower of Guruji. I recall many occasions when we would be sitting and listening spellbound to Guruji's interpretation of the Gita and the Upanishads. In several ways, Guruji greatly influenced Adityaji and me, and both of us got initiated into studying the Gita. We were seekers. Guruji would teach the Gita in such a simple manner. His commentary was highly educative. He would take shloka by shloka and explain its implications beautifully with analogies, making it easy to understand. Let me give you an example. To drive home the point that one should be focused in the present, Guruji talks about a farmer for whom the future is always carved out in the present. Tomorrow's harvest depends upon today's plowing and sowing. But in the fear of facing possible dangers to the crop, if a farmer fritters away his present chances of thoroughly plowing and carefully sowing at the right time, it is guaranteed that he shall not have any harvest at all. Guruji's message was that the present moments must be invested intelligently and well, so that we may reap a rich harvest. Another incident that I recount is when Guruji was talking about worldly attachments and how there is need to rise above it. He said that the antidote to all this, the addiction to power, to fame, to wealth, all of which pull one in the vortex of worldliness, is spiritualism, and that is through mind management. The mind may sway you, it can manipulate you, it controls you absolutely. So change the course of your mind, master the mind, said Guruji. This is one thought that has always stayed with me. Both Adityaji and I looked upon those years with Guruji as a blessing. We moved to Bombay in 1971. Guruji blessed our home here as well. Once he was down with fever, so Adityaji asked him whether he should give him a crocine or the Saridon. Guruji's reply was, "Ram Naam is my best medicine." Such was his faith in God. In conclusion, let me say that even today, we draw heavily upon Chinmayanandji's Gita. We find the teachings enlightening, and they give us enormous inner peace, tranquility. We are great followers of the Chinmaya Mission, and we are very privileged to have satsangs at a home conducted by Swami Swatmanandji. Ever so often, these draw upon Guruji's spiritual teachings. In our hearts, Guruji lives on forever. Thank you. Hari Om.